Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from OneHive Gazette, here with the next video, and this is a base identification video. And in this series, as you guys know, we take a look at different bases of all different levels, deconstruct them, talk about how they should be attacked, how they should be identified, as is the title, and then go ahead and show the attack and how it exploited certain parts of the base. So that being said, let's get started here with a Town Hall 11. Gonna do 110v11. They're so important these days. Can't not do it. This is a base that I've seen a few times in certain matchups, and I think it is a good base, but there's one clear weakness, and that is the fact that there is such an easy funnel over here because there's just nothing there. The dead space, which can screw you if you try to come from this side, it also serves as a funnel for one side. So just taking a look at the base here, basically if you funnel on this one side, which Tornado Top Links does, then you don't even have to funnel over here. Makes it really nice, especially for bowlers, to come through and overpower the base. So what he does is he gets a CC-ler with his funnel, which is always a good thing to do. If you can do part of your funnel, get the CC-ler, take care of it. Because by luring out the CC, he allows both his heroes to go for this town hall. And heroes are great at getting the town hall. They're much more reliable than bowlers or any kind of squishy troop like that. So let's go ahead and play the attack. Not a whole lot to talk about in terms of identification, except look for those natural funnels on the base and then look to get the CC lure with a funnel. So here's this funneling force. We see it all the time. A golem and about five bowlers behind. The rage spell, very important for those bowlers because it rages up the first and the second bounce. And then a few hogs sprinkled in just to get that CC lure, gets it done. Golem comes out. He's going to draw it to the corner. Of course, time is not a big issue in these 10v11 attacks. And because of that, he can afford to just bring it out and let a baby dragon kill it. So we'll fast forward through that part right here. Drops the baby dragon, killing the wizard first. Very smart. And then we'll just wait for about 30 seconds or so for the golemites to die. And as soon as they do, he'll start in with the next part of the attack at the top of the base, now that the funnel's been created. So two more golems, bowlers behind, and just a nice row of them. Doesn't even have to be that careful because the funnel is so good on both sides that they're all gonna go into the base here. Has the wall breakers to open things up just in time, and actually gets another layer opened up that he already had with the jump spell, but goes ahead and gets extra value with those raged wall breakers. Here comes the troops. I like how he dropped them at the top of the base because the funnel is better on that side, of course, because there's nothing there. So he wants to make sure they don't walk south too much. And even though he dropped them so far up, they still start to walk down a little bit. But luckily a few bowlers stay north and take out the town hall. Had plenty of force, just kind of almost missed that town hall, but he was able to drop those troops high enough that a few of them got in the town hall, and the queen, the king, doing some work, getting some extra percentage here. We'll fast forward to the end. As the queen dies, it'll be a 54%er. These 10v11, it's getting difficult. Not as difficult as 10v10, but you know, it's not that far from it. Especially because you don't have scouts. The scouts are used for 10v10 almost exclusively, or even bases that intend to be dipped. You can scout those too. We don't see the scout's the guy in front of you, basically, the guy who fails before you, if that happens, because we don't see a whole lot of fresh 10v11. But hey, for this weekend CWL talking, Genesis is really working on those 10v11s. We have a new system we're implementing. I'm kind of taking charge to a certain extent, and we're going to try to just crack out those Town Hall 11 bases, get them two-starred early on. So you guys will probably hear all about that. There'll be some more coverage I'll talk about later of the CWL matchup, as I've been hinting at over the last few weeks with the new setup and everything. So this next one, I forgot to talk about the base identification. I think the funnel kind of explains it right here. All these archer towers, expos, wizard towers in the middle of the base, perfect for dragons. Not a whole lot of HP though. Don't see many storages, just have the CC. That's about it. Look at this middle of the base. It's just begging for dragons, not to mention the king and the queen, which both create the funnel, because remember, dragons are like miners. They have to be funneled because they target any building. The heroes do the funnel, but also grab an air defense. That's important because air defenses are gonna hurt when you only have well, no lava hounds at all. So nothing that really tanked those air defenses. They just hit the dragons and the loons as they come in. So it has to take out those two air defenses. The heroes, the value from the heroes in this attack was nothing short of insane, because he got very, very wide, nice funnels to keep those dragons inside the base. But perhaps more importantly, they took out air defenses, which will no longer be an issue for the dragons. Just the two back end air defenses, but those can be dealt with. Sometimes we see a clone spell on this attack. I forget what it's called, like cloned bone or something weird like that. I think it's cloned bone. I'm not sure. But anyway, no clone spell here, just a bunch of rages and the heal spell. Those hasted loons, the air defenses can't take four loons with the haste. That will do it. And you can see the dragons stay inside the base because of the funnel and how quality it was. And by the time they're getting to this back end of trash, all the defenses are gone because this guy packed all his air targeting defenses in the core. When you see that, think dragons, that'll pretty much do it. Look at how many troops he has left up. I'd say, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dragons, the loons, a few of them just dropped right here to that lava pup, but had about 8 balloons left up to crush this base. Nice attack to black ice. Fast forward to the end here, great stuff, great base identification. If you see all that stuff in the core, add that to one of the go-to Town Hall 10 attacks. It's a situational one, it only works in the right bases, but that's how many attacks are, this one even more so. But if you see that type of base, go for it with the dragons, create the funnels, try to get a few air defenses while you're at it, haste loons into the other air defenses, and just try to get your dragons to stay in the middle of the base and keep them raged up as they go through. So pause on this next one here. I keep forgetting. sorry, guys. But anyway, this is a great base for hogs. First off, it has a small CC, not a lava hound, not a golem, but like minions and stuff like that. I forget what else it has. And the reason that matters is because you can bring the queen with the kill squad, which gets great value. So just brings a traditional one golem kill squad, has some valks, both heroes, wants to grab an inferno tower and get the local defenses, get the queen, the king taken out. Heroes are definitely important on hog attacks. And then the more important thing for base identification purposes is there's not many defenses in the cords. You have these air sweepers, but they're not really even defenses in terms of doing damage, and just not a whole lot else. And that allows great hog pathing. Look at this little lane for the hogs around the base. The Inferno Towers play very well into it. It's really some great value to be gotten, because the heal spell width, as I've said before, should not be less than the width of the hog lane. So it's a 2-defense-wide hog lane for the most part, and the heal spell can cover that, which means you can heal your entire group of hogs as they move through the lane. You don't have to worry about them spreading out too much, but they're not just going one defense by one defense. It's wide enough that they're getting value in multiple little groups within the lane, and that allows them to get through the base quickly and get the best value from those heal spells that you possibly can. So here's the attack. One thing that happens that wasn't expected for sure, and you think would ruin the attack, but doesn't. Interesting here, the Inferno Tower is not gonna go down. So watch as everything goes in, not the, you know, best Inferno Tower pathing. The queen gets drawn in by the CC troops, and a few Valks run towards the Inferno, but nothing that's gonna kill it. Gets actually pretty low right there, the Inferno Tower, but nothing to completely take it down. No rage spell. He needed 3 heals, and that's a good choice. With this much base, you have to have those 3 heals and the freeze for the Inferno. Just too much of a risk. Pops the queen's ability, but she still won't get a finger on that Inferno Tower. It will still have just a sliver of health left up. So 2 Inferno Towers, a ton of defenses. Granted, they're a little bit lower level, which on any attack makes it easier, but these defense targeting, not kind of more finesse attacks, are even more important to have lower level defenses. So the hogs move through here, a few more to support. To keep the hog lane narrow, he reinforces with hogs on these mortars. That way they're not gonna spread out too much, they're not gonna backtrack to the mortars. And right here, he was expecting that Inferno Tower to be down. It's not, which complicates things, but hey, he has so many hogs left up. Even though there's some giant bombs, the Inferno Tower, the Wizard Tower, he still has enough hogs to take everything out. And I like that poison. Just, he wasn't sure if there was gonna be a Skelly Trap there, but might as well drop it. We see so many attacks where people hold onto that poison for no reason, and they just never use it the entire attack. drop that thing. If you're getting towards the end, just drop it. And that was a great place to drop it by the Inferno Tower. What actually happened is the skellies already popped when the kill squad came in, but had the skellies been there, they would have instantly evaporated to that poison spell before they could touch the hogs. So good heads up stuff there, but great base identification in terms of the CC allowing the queen to be part of the kill squad, and more importantly, the hog pathing just being great on this base. Look for those lanes. They don't have to be straight. They just have to be narrow enough to fit within the width of a heal spell to keep all your hogs healed up. Okay, some 9v9. I think you guys are going to really like these attacks because they both include dragons. This first one, suicide dragons. And that's something that we don't see every day, but it has a time, it has a place, and this is the time, and this is the base. I guess a time and a base, not a time and a place. So these dragons are going to get some insane value. Because there's not many air defenses in the area, all the criteria are met. The queen is towards the outside, the king is there too for easy pickings. And look how separated the queen is from the king. Look how separated the queen and the king are from the rest of the base. When they're that separated, the dragons will do a few things. They'll take out the heroes for only 40 troops base investment. But more importantly, they free up the kill squad to come in from a much better spot. And look how great the pathing is. Because the defender intentionally put a little gap, some dead space between the hero compartment and the rest of the base, the pathing is just perfect. The boulders have nowhere to go but deep into the base here. So the don't be bound by where the heroes are. You can be creative with Suicide King, Skeleton Trap, Suicide Dragons, some way to take out the queen and then send your kill squad in at the other direction on the other side of the base, because the value from the kill squad is undeniable how great it was. The queen's going to sit back on that lava hound now, so the push is kind of going to stop right here. But by this point, there's only three defenses left up, has a big wad of hogs still moving through, and the queen's about to step up for more defenses. So crush this base. Only thing is the lava pups are going to be a bit of a nuisance here because there's no poison for them, but the queen will take care of a few, and he has enough troops left up to finish off the base. We'll fast forward the last 15 seconds here. A nice attack, and we'll take a look at one more now. Another dragon attack, like I said. This one bringing a few more of the birds down to 39. Yeah, 39. This is naughty, and I guess I kind of stopped pausing the... keep forgetting. I'll go ahead and pause it now. For this base... First thing that should stick out, all four air defenses on one side. That opens up different types of stuff, but I love the dragons when you have all four air defenses offset. Then you have a nice bunch of wizard towers, archer towers, the queen, just all kinds of great value, not to mention one of the expos is on ground. Really opens things up. And one thing that's nice about the dragons is you don't have to worry about them dealing with the queen, dealing with the CC troops. They can take care of all of that. So unlike hogs or balloons or something like that, that you have to constantly worry about the CC troops getting on them, the queen getting on them, the dragons are much more self-sufficient. And because of that, he doesn't need any poison spells. So he brings four quakes for the price of basically a jump spell by taking out those poisons, and still brings three other elixir spells, which allows him to drop those quakes. And I like the quakes. I've had a long history with the quakes. I've historically not been a big fan of them, but you got to admit the golems just move through so smoothly. Nothing has to jump. So that is one benefit. There's not the delay as troops jump over the wall when they can't attack anything. They just step right through like there's nothing there because the walls are down. And the pathing just seems to be better. I'm not sure if there's some kind of mechanic I'm missing, but the quake spell, you know, it does damage to defenses. It opens up a wider area. It does it permanently, and it takes away the jump aspect as troops have to jump over a wall and momentarily stop shooting or attacking or whatever. So gets great value with that kill squad, all four air defenses, good placement, good entry point, all that kind of stuff. Then here come the dragons, a little bit discombobulated with the dragons because they kind of start to group up on this town hall, but has enough of them inside the base that they'll start to take out some of these other buildings, get deeper in there towards the top. And because the kill squad took out the entire right side of the base, these dragons that were on the town hall now all group back up with a rage and a heal and take out these last defenses. Dragons, very popular, or very powerful, not that popular, but very powerful at town hall 9 when used correctly. And I like the quake spells paired with them. Good combination, nice attack to Naughty, identifying those air defenses and then taking out the rest of the base. That will do it, guys. Hope you liked the video. I will say this weekend, probably going to have a live with OneHive from the CWL War, maybe a live attack, and probably going to stream the last hour or so of the war. That's something I really wanted to do for a while, and now I'm going to be able to. We're going against King Jeffrey, one of the top clans, but the idea is to stream the Discord chat, the attacks, the planning, just give you guys the entire taste. So I'll make a video announcing that very soon if I'm going to do it. And yeah, more content from CWL coming up. Not doing the recaps at the moment, but I think this content might even be better doing the live action, some of the more exciting stuff in my opinion. So that will do it. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you guys later. Bisectatron out.